Welcome back to RLCS Overtime, ladies and gentlemen. One of my favorite parts about the show is that we get to talk to the players and pick their brains about how they feel about RLCS, how they feel about Rocket League. And today, we've got one of the players from Team Secret that we got to see debut here in Season 4. Tylacto is here. Tylacto joining us from university, from his dorm room, it looks like. How you doing, man?
I'm doing all right. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. Thanks for taking the time to talk to us. Always the first question to ask people whenever they're here on Overtime is, how did you get into Rocket League?
It's a pretty good story. I was I was just staying the night at one of my friends. It was like the Christmas holidays because Rocket League came out in like the July, August sort of time of 2015.
Yeah,
15. And I didn't know anything about the game. And come 2016, me and my friend, his name's DeAndre, cool guy, pretty cool name, and we found a game on PlayStation. And you're guessing it could have been Rocket League. No, we found Supersonic Acrobatic Rocket Power Battle Cars only like 7 or 8 years late. And we just thought, this game's awesome. This game is pretty damn good. I mean, it's pretty old, but it's pretty damn good. And so we played that all night. And a couple of weeks later, he's just like, you know Supersonic Acrobatic Rocket Power Battle Cars? It's got a sequel. And I'm like, oh, wow. I need to play this. So then I played it, and then I thought, oh, this is pretty cool. And then season one ended, like, by the time that I got the game, and I was, like, just made silver, and I'm like, get in there. And then I just played the game, and then I played it a bit more, and then I played it a bit more. And then to be honest, I just played it a bit more. And by the time it was the end of the year, I started competing in tournaments. But, yeah, I was a bit behind, so it's always been a bit of catch-up for me.
It's funny to me that, like, you technically, though, can call yourself a SARP vet, which was one of the things that people would always say, like, oh, the SARP vets, they have this advantage or whatever, even though you were, like, what is it, like 7 or 8 years late to finding the game?
Yeah, standard stuff.
Yeah, that's pretty fun. Was Rocket League your first, like, eSport involvement? Like, what was your background in eSports before Rocket League?
Yeah, it was the first game I properly played competitive. I've always like played games competitively and always been competitive, but a video game for me was always about enjoyment. And then I sort of played Rocket League, and I'm like, this is not about enjoyment. This is a sport. This is life and death. This is much more than entertainment. And then, yeah, that's why I sort of never really stopped. It always felt like the sort of high school movie where you get that guy who stays behind and shoots basketballs for like 2 hours and no one else is in the gym. Every time I go into free play, I feel like that. I'm just doing the same shot again and again and again. My brain's getting fried, but I'm still doing the same shot. But yeah, it's a bit obsessive, but I guess that's why I like it.
I feel like that's the story with many of the pros I've talked to as well, that they always had like a group of friends who were like, oh, let's play this game. They all got into it, and then all their friends like stopped playing, and they are the one person who stayed behind shooting the hoops for forever, and now you know them as the pros of Rocket League here. And talk to me about your teammates here. You were on the team first known as Aerialty when you qualified. Talk to me about finding Continuum and Flame and forming a team with them.
Okay, so it was after RLCS season something, that would have been season 3, I'd played under Small Town Girls. We were a bit of like, we didn't really have a chance to make it into league play, and we had a bit of a disappointing run. That was with Jakey Poo and Phoenix. They're great guys. And then we disbanded afterwards, because obviously if a team doesn't win everything, you got to disband the standard stuff. And then I sort of understood that Continuum had sort of been like dropped and a little bit screwed over by Leftovers, because he was one of their subs, and they were trying out Continuum. Mount and Farrah, and obviously Farrah got picked, so Continuum basically didn't get used for a season. They didn't get to play the game much, so he dropped off a little bit, and so that sort of brought him down to my standard. And it was sort of like, hey, play this game with me, and he's like, play this game with me, okay. And we had a lot of mutual friends, so it was fair enough, and we just started playing together, and then we thought, like, this would be okay. And we picked up Gontho initially, initial player. I think he appeared on the RLCS stream playing for Luminous in season 2. They nearly made it in beating Oh My Dog, but they lost to Oh My Dog. So we already knew he was a great player, and he's a really cool guy. And we played with him for a couple months. We got into the sort of top 10 teams in EU, and we're looking like, this is looking pretty solid. And then we realized, I think it was the Gontho might struggle to play the qualifiers. It was something like that. Either way, he ended up going to live in a medical center. It was quite unlucky because he's such a cool guy, and he's doing all right now. What matters. So we ended up having to find a new third, and then we're like, we kind of liked Gontho. We called him Gingon. Got to call him Gingon. That's a much better name. It was sort of like, well, who are we going to replace him with? And then we sort of like, oh, I don't really know who we're going to replace him with. And we tried out a few people, and then we ended up playing with Flame, because we're like, oh, well, no one's really played with, like, Flame was very still quite unknown at that time. We're like, you can hit the ball. Okay, we got someone who can hit the ball. That's kind of good. And then you realize, and then we just started playing, and we're like, yeah, this is good. Yeah, this will work. So we just started playing, and then it was good. I think if you spend too much time waiting for the perfect third, I think you'll be waiting your whole life. Mm. And it wasn't a perfect fit initially, and maybe it still isn't a perfect fit now, but we worked on it, and it worked, and we played a lot. And
for sure. Well, you've definitely made it work to some degree. I mean, you guys qualifying in to season 4 of RLCS, and just take me back to the beginning of the season. Walk me through the qualifiers from y'all's perspective, yeah, because you weren't the team that anyone was really paying attention to too closely here. But that game against Leftovers was crazy. How was it from your perspective?
Yeah, it was a long day. It started like 11 a.m. and we were going through upper bracket. We had a pretty scary run against SAR, that's like Charging Dingle, Money Talking Packer, and we dropped game one, and we were like 3-0 down in game two with like a minute to go, and I scored like 4 goals. It was kind of lucky, and we ended up taking that series. We took the series against Epsilon, and that meant we were safely in RLRS. So we're like, okay, we've sort of lived up to expectations. Now let's just screw someone over. And we played against Gale Force, and we're like, yeah, we're going to get, okay, never mind, we lost to Gale Force. And so then we went down to lower bracket, and then we went against Inspiration, that was Sebadam. I think playing at the time was Flakes and Ocelon or Lauti. No, I think it wasn't Ocelon, it was Lauti. And we went 2 games down against them because we just felt like we might as well make it difficult. So then we reverse swept them. And it was like, okay, we're in another stream game. We're playing Leftovers. And we knew that if we'd bracket went as predicted, which that was the like predicted bracket, then we'd be playing Leftovers. We'd actually been playing them the night before. And before leading up to RLCS, Leftovers were in really poor form. So considering the quality of the players, they've been playing very poorly. So we're like, okay, we fancy our chances. We'd scrimmed them the night before. I think we won 6-4 in games. And we're like, okay, we should win this. And because the quality of, like, they just weren't playing very well as a team. And so then, yeah, we had pretty close games on stream. Mm-hmm. And we're sort of just like physically shaking whilst you're holding your controller.
For sure.
And we're like, okay. And then it kind of tense and it goes to overtime. And I sort of score the winner in overtime. And it's like, okay, it's game one, and then he sort of goes to game two, and then I score the winner over time. I was like, okay, that's game two. Okay, well, we're going to get reverse swept now. And we figured we'd make it really entertaining for the fans. So we'd think, yeah, we'll make it think it's going to be a leftovers reverse sweep. So we let them get 2 games. But bear in mind that at the end of game two, my dad came into my room and was shouting at me, telling me that he's going to turn off the internet. And I was like, that's really good. So I basically had to be silent for the next 2 games. And
oh, wow.
I don't know. I'm pretty sure he like took the wire of the internet and started wiggling it around. Because if you check the scoreboard at the end of game 4, I had about 140 ping, which was kind of fun. And I'm like, looks like we've lost this then. And we go 1-0 down in game 5. And it's like, yep, I guess we've lost this then. And then I score. And then it's like 1-1. And then Flame scores. And it's like 2-1. And I'm like, oh, my goodness, we might not lose this. And then they equalize. And it's like, okay, yeah, we lost this. And then we're like, hang on a minute. Now, let's make it really entertaining. Let's take it 6 minutes of overtime. I mean, if you watch that back, I mean, I've watched it back quite a few times. It was just like the most like scared gameplay you'll ever see from both teams. Because Leftovers like, we can't lose this. Mm-hmm. Everyone will murder us for this. And we're like, we can't lose this because we should win this. Because we were the team in much better form. And it was like, in our heads, we knew that we should win it, and it just put pressure on us. I made a save where I had 0 boost, and I jumped from the inside of the goal. Mm-hmm. Don't know what made me do that, but I just did. So it was there was this sort of like thing in the air. You could sort of knew that we were sort of destined to win
sure.
for some reason. And then it comes like 5 minutes 49 seconds, and then I score the goal, and yeah. It's like, I couldn't make any noise because my dad would kill me. So I was just like,
well,
so
I mean, at that point, you'd already won. You'd already qualified. Yeah. If you pulled the internet, it wouldn't really matter, right?
But That's true. I sort of see the ball floating in, and I know it's in. And I just go, it's in. That's it. I just took off my headset and left. And I could hear Ollie Continuum was just screaming, like, yeah.
Yeah, for sure.
And Flame is usually quite quiet. He was just like, get in. And he was going like proper hyped. And I'm just like, oh, that's fine. I'm just going to go have like a shower now. Yeah. And I came back.
Just gonna calm down. Had a crazy day of Rocket League there, and you guys go through. You make it to season 4. Have like not the best of seasons for you guys. Now you're in the RLRS here. You're like, what are your expectations looking at RLRS for season 5? You know, like, how do you feel like how you match up against the rest of the rival series?
It's really quite difficult because we're gonna be expected to make top 2, like pretty much uncontested. But that's not gonna be the case. RLRS is going to be very stacked. I wouldn't be surprised if, like, it's just, like, we've already got Endpoint qualified in there. We always have good games against Endpoint. They're a great team. I'd like it if they made top two, but we have a very good record against them, so I trust us to take it against them. As for Juicy Kids, they'll have a new third, possibly Jayzer, but, yeah, that's not a fun team to play against because Stocky does so many random stuff. And the other team is X-Ray, but I don't know if they'll keep their place. I mean, I'm not... it's difficult. I just, because there are some teams like Reason and other great teams that should qualify that really would give us a hard time. And there's no team that I could just say, yeah, well, that's a win. I mean, last season, pretty crazy teams made it in, like Soul Gaming and Golden Hawks. And then by the end of the season, teams were like, okay, yeah, that's a win when you go against them. And this is going to be a very scary season. That's what it's going
to
be.
For sure. And you're having to play from uni here for the first time. How are you feeling you're going to have to balance the two between the university and your professional Rocket League career?
Yeah, I just basically play whenever I can, and I don't really know when that's going to be. It makes finding practices kind of hard. But I mean, I usually tend to know that I'm going to get the evenings, but it just depends how much work I have to do. I'll schedule like a practice, like maybe 7:30 in the evening, and then I get to like 7:20. I'm like, I've got this pile of physics, and it's like, and let me just push this to the side, and it's just like pushing with all my pile of papers. But yeah, it's definitely not been ideal. It's reduced the amount of hours I can put in, but it's made me enjoy playing the game more because it makes me appreciate the time that I earn to play the game, and I am putting in the hours. And I was worried that I wouldn't be able to put enough hours, but I tried as hard as I can to put as many in, and now I know that I can put in the hours.
That's awesome. Great. I love that, because like the distance is making the heart grow fonder, that you're enjoying Rocket League more because you can't spend as much time with it. That's kind of cool. Hard-hitting question here. We're running out of time, but Psionics Corey, the eSports Corey, wanted me to ask this, and so this is, you be ready for this. What's your favorite color?
Orange.
Orange. Okay, cool. There, Corey, you've got your answer, man. Thank you so much, Tylacto, for taking the time to talk to us. Any shout-outs you got before I let you go?
Yes. Subpar but in HD, also known as Team Rocket, formerly known as Team Rocket, The Freezer, and Raphro98.
Okay, I don't know who the Freezer is, so I'm just gonna assume it's like actually your literal freezer.
It's a community, and plus my freezer as well. That's where I keep my food.
Awesome, Tylacto. Thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us. Good luck in RLRS.
Thank you.
Awesome. That is Tylacto there from Team Secret. Always great to hear from the players here on Overtime. When we come back, roster watch. We're gonna break it down. Talk about which teams do we think might be making some changes, which ones are staying the same. What we can expect here for season 5. That and more when we come back to Overtime.